Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Organisms and Environment. In that, we are studying topic Conservation of Biodiversity. When I say conservation, it means to preserve. And when I say biodiversity, it means flora and fauna included plants, animals and different species. Let us study how we are going to do that. Conservation of biodiversity in simple terms means to conserve the flora, fauna, that is plants, animals, birds, reptiles, everything present on this biosphere for the present generations and the future generations to come so that they can use it. Now, the UN government along with the state governments and the country governments do it in two different manners. First is the in-situ conservation, or you can say the ex-situ conservation, and another is the in-situ conservation. Now, when I talk about the in-situ conservation, it means protecting the animal or that particular species in their natural habitat. For example, protecting an animal in the forest itself, that's an in-situ conservation. When I talk about ex-situ conservation, it means removing that animal from its natural habitat and protecting it at some safer place. For example, tortoise, when you keep it in the natural habitat of a river and protect it over there, then that is in situ conservation. But when you remove that tortoise and keep it in another zone and or at another place inside a cage where water is present, that will be ex situ conservation. When I talk about conservation of biodiversity, to conserve natural resources so that the present and future generation can use it wisely. It is up to us how we use the biodiversity natural resources, which is different animals, birds, reptiles, plants, all of them, so that everybody present on earth till the end of the universe can use it wisely and properly. To conserve biodiversity, in situ conservation is widely used, in which an organism is preserved, or you can say protected, when it is found out to be endangered in its own natural habitat. And in situ conservation is the best form of conservation, since the organism or the species won't feel homesick and it can sustain and grow and feel protected among species which are its own self or which are similar. Ex situ conservation means protecting organisms or endangered species outside their natural habitat. India is the first country to adopt this Wildlife Protection Act 1972. Students, in this part of the topic of conservation of biodiversity, we have studied about two different types, in situ conservation and ex situ conservation. It doesn't matter which is the form a country or a government is applying. The whole and the sole aim has to be conservation of endangered species or vulnerable species or species or which are almost on the verge of extinction. If we don't do that, then there will be a point where most of the species would be lost, as we have already lost few of the vulnerable species and it is never possible to get them back, even with technology and science. I hope y'all are clear with this concept of species protection. Thank you.